set to strike gold in the regional sporting meet. Now let's get to know the members of the Philippine Kendo team here in the studio. Let's all welcome Christopher Inting, Loida Estanilla Inting, Ronald Villarroya, and Jerome Bautista. I got your names right, right?
Yes, yes.
Natatakot ako sa inyo. I'm kidding. Good morning. Welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being here.
No, thank you for having me.
This morning, wala naman traffic. No, it is a holiday. Okay, Sir Chris, I'll start with Sir Chris. Give us a brief background of what Kendo is and yung distinction from kasi alam natin Kendo, it's from Japan, correct?
Yes.
So what's the difference of this form of martial arts from other forms of
The main difference is because it's an armed martial art. So you practice with swords.
Mm-hmm.
So you practice with swords, you wear armor for protection, and then then that's the main difference, because most martial arts are unarmed, and then that's the main difference, yeah.
Okay, you have sticks, you said. Is it parang similar, because I remember back in college, PE, arnis.
Yeah.
Parang arnis.
It's similar in sense we practice with the sticks, but yeah. We practice in such a way that it has to feel like a sword.
Like you're holding a samurai sword.
Basically,
correct?
Yes. Yeah, you're holding a Japanese samurai sword, yes.
And then it's just one-on-one battle, diba?
Right? And one-on-one battle.
Yeah, it's like fencing, but in a Japanese way.
Yeah.
Okay. Loida, Ronald, and Jerome. Kayo naman, I'm gonna ask, how did you get into this sport? Loida, ikaw, paano ka na like, sa Kendo?
Oh, it was because of him. Because at that time...
So you started...
I started earlier.
Yeah, okay. He started earlier. And then we just got back together. We broke up before. And then we just got back together.
Yeah, may love story
and
pa.
One of the things that he wanted to share with me when we got back together was Kendo. So he brought me to one of the practice sessions. And then, you know,
Akala ko, okay. No, that's a good story. It's a cute story.
So now we're married.
No, you're married. Basta wala namang... Akala ko, we work it out. Okay. Of course, Loida is women's team captain,
yes.
Correct? Okay, and then how about you, Ronald? How did you get into the sport of Kendo?
I started Kendo late in the 2000. There was no internet yet that time, so it's hard to find a dojo that time. So a client of mine mentioned that there is a group of people practicing Kendo in the Makati Sports Club.
Okay.
And one Saturday, I got curious and I joined that club, which I'm still a member of that club until now.
That's how you met Chris? No?
It was earlier.
It was earlier.
It was around 1999. And I was also a samurai movie enthusiast.
Ah, that's why.
Yes.
So you love, of course, samurai movies. And then you wanted to get into the sport.
I want to feel how it is done, something like that.
Yeah.
And I thought Kendo is the closest thing to...
It is.
Samurai.
Yeah. Discipline.
Yes.
The way you strike, diba? The way you battle your opponent. Okay, see, Jerome naman, how did you get into the sport?
So I started Kendo in February 2015 or March 2015.
Okay, so just a few years ago, four years ago. Okay.
And my cousin caught me searching for Japanese swords.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to buy one to display at our house.
Okay.
So and then he said that, is it for Kendo? And then I was like, no, it's just for display. And then I searched up Kendo, so
okay.
In Google, and I saw Iga Kendo Club.
Ang ganda ng story, ano? You have your own different stories on how you got into the sport. Ronald, I'll go back to you. You are the current champion of the men's division, but I understand you went into a 10-year hiatus kasi sabi mo 1999-2000, you got into the sport. And then, when did that break happen? Kasi that's difficult to in any sport, to be away from the sport 10 years, and then... you made your comeback. Why? What happened?
I had other priorities back then, so I have to prioritize first my family, so I have to get into rest for almost 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
Then Kendo is a philosophy, it's a way of life. So even if you're not practicing it, you can apply it into many things.
Okay.
The philosophy is intrinsic to the teaching of Kendo. So even if you just do daily things, you can still apply it.
Di ba mahirap na mawala ng 10 years? Sabi mo nga, you can still do it in your daily life. Pero di ba, to get back in shape, to get back...
Yes, definitely.
Mawala ka 10 years.
I had a hard time coming back kasi... it's not easy to be not around for 10 years, then suddenly you get back into the sports. But
it's hard.
Kendo is a practice of muscle memory also. So if you learn things diligently every day, you learn things using your muscle memories, everything will come instinctively and automatically. So probably that's one thing that made it easier for me to practice kendo after being not around for 10 years.
I see. Okay, now as Jerome, actually batang bata, how young are you, Jerome?
22.
And you are the, kumbaga, pinakabata, isa ka sa pinakabata sa team, di ba?
Oh.
And then, pangalawang tournament mo pa lang yung sasalihan sa Indonesia, di ba, sa yung second ASEAN tournament na sasalihan mo. Kamusta yung first tournament mo, and ano naman yung, kumbaga, may mga goals ka ba na inaay kagad in this tournament that will happen in Indonesia?
Actually, the first AKT tournament, yung first ko po is, I was just watching the Philippine team. So I was just training with them, watching them.
Observing.
Yes, I was just observing. And then when I was training with them, I had the mindset that the next AKT, I would be with them, I would be competing with them, and I would be one of the representatives. And my goal is to bring home a medal for my team and for the country.
So. How prepared are we to bring home a medal, Sir Chris, in the 12th ASEAN Kendo Tournament happening in Jakarta, Indonesia? How prepared is this team?
Honestly, this team, it's the preparations have been long and hard. So we've been practicing since earlier this year as a team.
Mm-hmm.
We've also gathered players from all over the country. Like we have representatives from Davao and Cebu. And these are up-and-coming kendo players also from in the Philippines. So in terms of getting medals, I believe we have the capacity to get medals this time. We just need to polish off our training and then we just have to go there and show our best, do our best.
What's your realistic target? In terms
realistic
of
target, we're looking at the very least, we're looking at maybe two or three top eight finishes.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
In the individuals,
yeah.
We have two or three players who are very promising, and that's just potential.
Yeah,
definitely we can see them also getting top four, maybe even fighting the finals.
Okay, Ms. Loida, since you are the team captain of the women's team, how do yung mga members? How were the members of the Philippine team kumbaga selected?
The selection process started maybe a year or two in advance, because the ASEAN Kendo tournament only happens every 3 years.
Every 3 years, okay.
So we have the national tournament that we hold every year, and then from those national tournaments, the higher ranking sensei here in the Philippines would select from the best players from those events. And then invite them to become part of the training pool for the national team.
How many delegates are we sending?
25.
25.
14 men, 11 women.
14 men and 11 women. Okay, we're not done with you guys just yet. We're going to stop the clock for a bit. But later, the Philippine Kendo team will show us what it makes this Japanese martial arts unique. And maybe I can learn a thing or two. And a Dream Mad Teen all-time advantage. And we still have with us this morning members of the Philippine Kendo team. And they will give us a demo of the sport and also teach me the basics. Okay, Master.
Okay, so,
sir,
in Kendo, there are four basic target areas. The head, here, men.
Mm-hmm.
The forearm, kote.
Mm-hmm.
The torso, do. And the throat or ski.
Okay, so one, two, three, and four.
Yeah.
All right.
So we'll be demoing those four basic targeting
okay.
Right now.
Wait.
Surashimen. Sashimen.
Sir, ba't hindi lumalaban yun?
He's just to demo right now.
Demo lang. Yeah. Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay, next. Kote. Surashi Kote. De Kote.
Kailangan yata dito ako, no? Mas malayo. okay, sige.
Next, Surashi Do. Next. Surashi Ski. So those are the four target areas.
Four target areas,
yeah.
Okay, which you just showed. And by hitting, you get a point, right?
You get a point, yes.
Okay.
In tournaments, it's usually first to 2 points.
Okay, the time right now is 10:57. We still have time. Do we demo na maglalaban or you want me to try? Can
You can try first. Yeah.
Pero wala akong helmet.
It's okay. You just want to hit.
Wag mo tatamaan, bro.
Okay, so this is live TV. Okay, sir. So I, how do you hold the
first left hand at the bottom of okay. the handle and okay. right hand near the
all right
near the sword guard.
Okay.
And again,
and you like this, right?
Yes, right foot forward.
Okay.
So basically, when you lift, you slide your right foot forward.
Mm-hmm.
When you lift the sword above your head, and when you hit, close your left
okay.
foot.
Okay. Okay.
And shout as you hit.
Hindi po pala laban siya?
No.
Okay. Sama ng tingin. Okay. Ready, sir? Oh, what do I shout?
Just shout.
Shout?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's your okay. battle cry. So shout.
Like, ah, and
anything. Okay. Yeah.
Sorry. All right, sir. Give the go signal.
All right. Go.
Ah, okay. One more. All right. One, two.
Ah! There. So, man.
Oh, nice.
Okay. And then you can try the kote or the forearm.
Okay.
Same thing?
Here, right?
Here.
Like that?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. All right.
Go.
Hey. Sorry.
Okay. Okay. Anyway, it's part of our training that we learn how to do. We learn how to,
synthesize pain. Okay, and then the...
And then we try the torso.
Which?
On your left side.
Like that?
Yes, like that.
Okay. All right.
Sige, sir.
Show.
Yeah. Go. There. Very good.
Okay, thank you. Wow. Siya naman, babawi siya.
No.
Thank you so much. Wow. Philippine Kendo team here on SportsS. Maraming salamat for being here. The best of luck, sir, sa Jakarta,
Indonesia.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you also for showing us the basics and for helping us out here. Maraming salamat. And there goes the final buzzer. But don't worry, more sports stories will come your way tonight. You can catch SportsS. Charles Steele is back at 10 p.m. I'm Andre Felix. I'll see you again tomorrow at 10:30 a.m. right after Newsroom ngayon. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.